Hi there, and welcome to a Point Lobos Botany Blast Tree Talk. That's right, it's time for a conifer conversation. Let's go hiking. And we'll stop right here at this incredibly rare conifer tree known as the Monterey Cypress. Point Lobos is one of only two places on the entire planet where this conifer grows naturally. It has been planted elsewhere, but this place right here, and just across the bay, not far from here, is the other place where this tree grows naturally. Let's take a closer look to see what makes the Monterey Cypress a Monterey Cypress. Let's begin with the leaves right here. They're scale-like and kind of feel like reptile skin. They've got this waxy coating over them that helps prevent water loss. The scent, when I rub on these leaves, smells like lemons, which I find to be quite pleasing. But I haven't observed any of the herbivores of our forest chomping on this. So I don't see the deer or the squirrels or the rabbits or anything else biting into this. So maybe it's a combination of the waxy coating and that scent that might deter herbivory, which is a great science word, by the way, herbivory. So taking a look at the leaves, let's see what else we can see on this tree that will help us define it. Oh, here we go. Right over here, this is what gives it its conifer status, its cone. Look at that. Now I realize it's not a cone shape, it's more of a mini soccer ball or volleyball, but it holds the seeds of the Monterey Cypress. And within this small rounded cone can be up to 140 seeds. Let's see if we can find one. We're in luck. Check it out. Let me bring these right up to our camera. You can see the cone right here, and then we have four seeds of the Monterey Cypress. These seeds about the size of a tomato seed, an oatmeal flake, or even the size of a redwood seed, for those of you who know about the redwoods. It is amazing to think that these trees that are surrounding us have germinated from a seed that size. So the cone and the seeds will also help us identify the Monterey Cypress. Another thing we can look at to help identify the tree is the trunk and the bark on the trunk. Let's take a closer look at this. We can see that the bark is grayish in color. It's got these deep furrows running more or less vertical in a straight line up and down the trunk. The bark itself is simultaneously, you know, hard to press on, but kind of soft to gently push on right here, a little springy. It's slightly reminiscent of the springy bark of redwood. So we've got this gray bark with deep furrows running up and down the tree. And we can see that that's a pattern in other Monterey cypresses around here. Looking at the leaves, the fruit, and the bark and trunk of a tree, as well as knowing the location, can help you identify it. The next step would be to consult a guidebook or go online with those characteristics to help you identify that tree. Here at Point Lobos, all these characteristics add up to one tree here, and that's the Monterey Cypress, a beautiful, rare cypress tree growing only here at Point Lobos, as well as across the Carmel Bay. Thank you for joining me for a Point Lobos Botany Blast conifer conversation.